to Gamesmaster, where there's quite literally loads of people in Atlantis today. Is it A, a Stalkers of Dominic Diamond convention, B, a Stalkers of Gabby Roslin convention, who've taken the wrong turn off the M25, or C, a lot of people wearing the same t-shirt for some kind of Gamesmaster event type situation? If you're very thick and don't know the answer to that one, we'll reveal it after today's news. The Japanese are mad, generally, especially about video games. Expert players over there are celebrities adored by millions. The biggest sensations of all are the masters of Japan's most popular game series, Virtua Fighter. Known as Tetsujin, or Iron Men, they have earned their fame by successfully completing the Iron Man Initiation Rite, in which they take on 100 expert Virtua Fighter players in a row. They have to beat at least 90 of them, a feat achieved without rest or sustenance. Only five people have passed this test, and last June the nation came to a standstill as Tetsujin's Bun Bun Maru and Kiyosawa fought on live TV in the final of the Grandmasters tournament to establish the ultimate champion, a title won eventually by Kiyosawa. So how good is he? Well, we've flown him over to England to replay his Iron Man test against the cream of British players. It's an event we call, quite simply, Tetsujin.
Now, obviously, there's no way we could possibly fit 100 Virtua Fighter challenges into the show, so this challenge has been going on for hours. Obviously, I'm far too important to have to come in early enough to do it. Dave Perry isn't, and he unselfishly agreed to come in since dawn. Dave, what's been happening?
Well, Dominic, it's been a spectacular day so far. It all started early this morning when Tetsujin arrived.
An interpreter was on hand to help out, and after the usual formalities, it was time for the Games Master to lay down the challenge.
Greetings. You, my challenger, will today take the first Iron Man test to be held in the UK. In accordance with the strict laws of this ancient event, you'll have to beat 90 out of the 100 opponents I've gathered to play you here today. You'll have no second chances. There'll be no excuses. 90 must fall.
Well, 100 players certainly sounded tough, but our Tetsujin was far from intimidated.
Do you think you can do it?
90人に勝てると思いますか?
いや、全然問題ないですよ。もう100でも200でも。
No problem, he can beat 120, 200, no problem at all.
No problem, you're going to do it easily. Okay then. They don't think so, take him to the machine, let's get it on.
And so up stepped the first of our brave players to the new Virtua Fighter 3 arcade machine, the first Brit ever to take on a Japanese Tetsujin.
Fight one, ready, go!
Well, Tetsujin played as ninja character Cage, and the action was swift and brutal. In a matter of seconds, he had claimed his first skull for the day. Others were soon to follow.
New challenger! K.O. New challenger!
Tetsujin. He's going home. Not with his title anymore. That's my title.
So spoke Mark Denton, challenger number 20 and a Street Fighter champion himself. But his air of confidence was to be short-lived.
K.O.
Well, he is the master, isn't he? And he sure lives up to his name. Very good indeed.
But Tetsujin stuck to a repertoire of moves, including the vaulting head smash, and took full advantage of Virtua Fighter 3's dodge function. But above all, it was the sheer speed of his reactions that set him apart. In fact, he was all over his opponents before they knew what had hit them. Some of our fighters, though, had tactics of their own.
Well, I'm going to try and get in quick with Jackie, get a few kicks in, a few punches, and just hope the best, really.
Basically, I'm just going to hammer the buttons as fast as I can and hope that I hit him.
But no, as the competition went on, player after player found their every move counted, every block useless. Here's opponent number 40. An opponent number 60. With the Tetsujin yet to concede a single bout, it really does seem as if he's unstoppable.
No move.
Well, it was tougher than I thought, actually. I went in really confident, thinking I'd win, but it was really good, and I really didn't stand a chance at all.
He's definitely a hard man, you know what I mean?
I've learned a lot today. Sure. K.O.
Incredible.
OK, and now, at this point, the Tetsujin has beaten 84. People, I've halted the action here because I'm sure he wants to have a chat with me as well. Naomi, could you ask him? He's played 84 people. How's it been going so far?
84人と戦ってきてどうですか、これまで。この調子だと自己ベストが98。His best score is 98. So he wants to renew his.
He thinks he can even beat that?
Yeah.
Okay, I'd like to wish you the very best of luck for challenger number 85, if you'd like to return to the machine. And I'll go up to the commentary box. Okay, so off we go for contestant number 85.
Ready, go!
So if we look at the screen again, he's coming in very, very fast. Would you say, Dave, one of the reasons he does so well is he doesn't give his opponent time to do anything else?
No, his reflexes, the Tetsujin's reflexes seem to be very, very swift. He also favours this cage character. He hasn't changed from him all day, so he knows the character extremely well, whereas our opponents maybe don't know their characters quite so well.
Fantastic there, really, that was superb! Fantastic, kind of double somersault mid-throw leaves his opponent quite literally flopped on the deck.
Ready, go!
Is there anything, I mean, is he using the full range of Cage's move here? Does he know the character so well?
Yeah, he does. He's using them. What he's doing, he's using a move called retraction, whereas he's coming in with a move and then he blocks it to stop himself from doing it, which is fooling his opponents and allowing him to counterattack whilst they're off guard. And he's using that an awful lot. He also seems to be very good at these aerial throws, as you saw just now when he sealed his excellence.
He's taking a bit of a pounding in this particular bout, though, Dave. Why is that? Tiredness or...?
I think maybe he's just got a little bit cocky. I think maybe it's been so easy for him up to now that Lion and our challenger are catching him off guard. We've only got to take one small energy bar.
Oh, and that's it. He was lulling his opponent into a false sense of security almost there. That's win number 85 under the Tetsujin's belt while we wheel in number 86. Let's take a look at today's reviews. Fox Hunt is a game about posh people shooting undefended woodland creatures. No, it's not, but we'll probably still get complaints now.
This plays a lot like D did on the Saturn and PlayStation, with the directions moving from one sequence of film to another piece, with the X button being used to activate items on screen. Occasionally, there are other characters in the game, which you sometimes get to fight, which is quite a bit more exciting. But overall, the game's just not funny and it's just not good.
Later on in the game, you actually do get to skydive, ski, dodge bullets, dodge Russians. It's your typical secret agent affair. It pretends to be fun.
OK, we interrupt all those reviews there, not because we thought they were particularly appalling, but because the Tetsujin might be in trouble with his 89th challenger, Omar. Omar has nearly shoved the Tetsujin off the roof, which would have given him a ring out if he'd have won that there. Dave, is he getting cocky again now?
I think he's got a bit cocky. He's got his energy bar knocked as low as we've seen it in this challenge, and the fight is being taken very, very near to the edge. They're both teetering on the edge of this roof.
Omar's nearly off the edge of the roof. He's got to be careful.
He's reversing
now.
He's reversing it, though. He's got around the other side of the Tetsujin.
Oh, he's tried to get off. He's lost the roof. He's lost the roof. That last Tetsujin has lost the first fight. Brilliant play by Omar. Could we be seeing the Tetsujin finally defeated on a best of three fight? Okay, let's look at the second one there. The Tetsujin's going to be miffed now, Dave.
Yeah, he is. He's going to come back with a vengeance, I think. He's going to really come looking for revenge. Look at the energy on Pi already, the top right-hand corner. It's well low.
He's coming back fighting, but so is Omar. Omar is pirates leading the very lovely kind of yellow cut-off jumpsuit. Nice thing, it's very fashionable among young ladies nowadays. But both the energy bars are low, but here comes the Tetsujin again, Dave.
Yes, he's going to take one big throw. There it is.
That's all it.
Even.
Over the shoulder and a little kick in some place to finish off with this one bout each, but There is still a chance then that Omar might cause the first upset of the day. Here we come for the third and final bout with the Test Region start up again with another one of those throws. Is the best... Oh
that's beautiful.
Is the best hope to hope for another ring out again then for Pai?
It probably is the way it's going because he looks really miffed now, the Tetsuji. He's not giving anything away. That's
that
clean.
That was absolutely devastating. The lesson is, you don't mess with a Tetsuji, but Omar did the best anyone has today. So let's go and have a word with the cheeky little monkey. Okay, right, Omar, you managed to hike him off the roof in that bout, but then it started to go a bit downhill after that. What happened?
Well, I don't know, he just caught me by surprise because I got some moves, you know, I lost.
Right, and you know we quite literally stopped our reviews because we thought you were going to win.
I know.
And you didn't.
And?
How do you feel?
Not in the slightest bit, so.
You don't, you're diffident.
Yeah.
Have you been taught that word at school?
Yes.
Excellent. Okay, well, thank you, Omar. The future of the country lies in the hands of men like him. Okay, then, he's on the number 89 then, so it looks as if during this commercial break, there's a very good chance he will beat Games Master's target of 90. However, our final 10 are extremely hard competitors indeed. We're going to see if he can get to the full 100. If that wasn't enough, after years of begging me, we finally allowed Coronation Street's Tracy Shaw to come on the show. All of that coming up in part two. See you in a moment. Games Master, what can I tell you about the Tetsujin? Well, he's a bloke from Japan. We've flown him over. He is rock hard at games and he's got a nice linen jacket as well. We left him as he was beating contestant number 89 today. During the break, he's beaten numbers 90, 91 and 92. Now, Games Master's original challenge was to beat 90. Nobody has caused him any problems. He's only lost one single bout. The question is, can he actually go all the way and do the big 100? We have got contestant number 93 up just now, and he's just got another KO, Dave. He is looking still fantastic in spite of being playing all day.
Well, that's right. He's not. Since that one round he lost, he's not lost another one since. He's been perfect all the way through.
That's incredible, because these last 10 we've got are some of the hardest arcade players we can find in Britain, and he's going through them like sliced bread, as Derek Lynch would say.
That's right, he's going through them like a hot knife through butter, and that's another KO.
That's it, it's over! Completed. These are supposed to be the hardest people this country has to offer, and the Tetsujin is still just romping through them. Well, technically, I haven't shaken hands or even kissed a famous person for a long time now, which is why we have to now go to today's Celebrity Challenge.
Today, my contestant will be heading off for a spin in a winter wonderland, thanks to the marvellous new snowboarding attraction, Alpine Surfer. Using a real snowboard to guide themselves, their task will be simply to get to the bottom of the mountain before the clock runs out.
Okay, let's get pieced.
And please welcome tonight's special guest. As Coronation Street's Maxine, she makes the north of England seem almost hospitable. Please welcome Tracy Shaw. Welcome to the show, Tracy.
Hello.
Now, Tracy, if Coronation Street is supposed to be such an accurate rendition of life in the North, how come everyone has jobs?
Now, what are you trying to say about
it? Every time I've been there, they've just been kind of like standing around on the street.
No, it's not like that at all.
Okay, let's talk about Maxine. Basically, you've been intimate with a lot of gentlemen on the show. You've had Des, Andy, Tony. Mm. What about Percy? What's wrong with him?
Well, Percy takes a bit of getting to, really. I've got to work my way around him.
Uh-huh. Probably it's because he's old and he wears about 40 layers of clothing. And finally, I have to mention, you were voted Reader of the Year last year, an award which I've actually won for the previous three. what did you have to do for that?
Well, I didn't do anything, really.
Right.
I just wore tight pants on the street.
Uh-huh. And let your buttocks do the talking.
Exactly.
Really, something which I talk out of quite a lot of time as well. Right, Tracy, it's quite a slippy wee snowboard that you're on there. We have watched you falling off a number of times in practice. Very amusing, but not televisually fantastic. So we're going to give you these pair of trendy trainers. I'm sure you've seen them on the streets of Manchester.
I certainly have.
Usually stolen from some unsuspecting child's foot. So if you'd like to slip those on and assume a snowboarding position, I will get a safe distance away for various legal reasons I don't have to get into. And while Tracy gets her trainers on, Derek Lynch is going to bring my hormones back to a less raging level. Derek, have you got any tips for Tracy on this?
Yes, well, tracers should try and keep to the correct side of the gates. Uh-huh. You can gain 2 seconds on a time for that.
Okay.
And also try and hit the ramps as straight as possible. But if she goes at an angle on the ramps, she'll get a performer air trick.
Right, okay then.
Yeah.
And Tracy has to get down to the end of the race with a near lot of time. It's quite literally that simple. Best of luck, Tracy. Off you go. No! Okay, so off Tracy goes in the top, in the middle of the screen that you can see the timer counting down. She will get a time extension about halfway down. That little plus two thing meant she was going the correct side of the gates. The arrow will show her the side of the gate to go through, but generally it's the left side of the blue ones, the right side of the right ones. A good start from her, Derek.
That's right. She's using good hip technique there and controlling it, and she's avoiding hitting the fences, which is good, but she's missing some of the gates, which is a bit sad, but...
Okay, she looks as if she looks fantastic. That's great.
She hit that ramp perfect.
Okay, and 44 seconds left. Got another gate the right side up there. She's actually, if you look in the top, you can see she's hit 10 out of 13 gates. So that's quite good as well, Derek.
Yeah, very good. She's moving quite well. Another ramp. Nice air trick there, little spin.
That was good. That will, of course, the longer she stays in there, the less of the bumps that she'll hit, which follow the ramps. You can see a map in the top right-hand corner as well. You can see her progress. She's over halfway down. 31 seconds left. That's some nice air she grabbed there, Derek, as well.
Going through the gates.
That's Derek. That's okay. I understand. You were looking at Tracy and not the screen. Bad boy. Okay. Luckily, some of us are professionals here. Okay. 25 seconds left. That's the final checkpoint there. Into the final quarter. This is good, Derek. I think she might do it here.
Yes, it looks like she's doing very well.
Oh no! And thank you, Derek. Puts the kiss of death onto Tracy there. Okay, good. A bit of a tight left hander there. Want to get the left side.
Oh, she's hit the screen.
I didn't hear that in your tips before, Derek. I didn't hear you say it. Okay, 30 seconds left, but the end is in sight. I think this is because she's going to do it. She's still it. Tracy Shaw. But that was a dog. Was it all the trainers? Did they help a lot?
I think it was the trainers, actually, yeah.
What I was wondering, actually, earlier, and I forgot to ask you before, is do you get any say in the plot lines of Coronation Street?
No.
Because I had this great idea, right, that Maxine could fall in love with this guy who comes on, right, physically not very attractive, wears glasses, but very amusing. Do you think that could work?
Well, maybe.
Because Chris Evans needs the work, I've heard. Boom, boom! Right, thank you very much for coming with Tracy. It's been a delight to see you, as I always say. Always nice to have someone on a fancy. So, the Games Master Golden Joystick goes to tonight's special guest, Miss Tracy Shaw. My plans weren't soiled enough. We still have the rest of our Tetsujin event to catch up upon. Mr. Dave Perry, how's it going?
Well, it's all very exciting. The Tetsujin has just beaten his 99th opponent, but we thought we'd pause here for dramatic effect because it's not going all his own way now. He's lost a couple of rounds. Sneakily, we saved some of our best fighters for last. And I'm going to take a look at some highlights now to look at the rounds we managed to nick off the champion. OK, this is round 95, and this is only the second round he's lost in the whole day. As you can see, both energy bars at the top of the screen are very, very low. But the Tetsujin looks in control, but here comes Lau, fighting back, his energy bar way down. He catches the Tetsujin with a roundhouse kick, knocks him out, only the second round he's lost of the day. And this is strange behaviour from the Tetsujin. We don't know whether he was tiring at this point or just toying with his opponents, because in fight 96, he seemed to be in control. He stormed into an early lead against Sarah Bryant, and then just as he looked to be dominating, she came back with a flurry of punches and a roundhouse kick that sent him to sleep. Beautiful KO. And that was the third round our fighters had taken off him today. Well, after losing those two rounds, the Tetsujin wasn't prepared to lose anymore. Once again, in round 98, he was having trouble with Sarah Bryant as she piled into him. But by now, he was warming to the task of possibly beating 100 of our contestants, and he immediately came back with some beautiful moves. Look at that aerial throw. Sarah goes crashing to the sand. It's only going to take one kick now to finish her off. Great fighting from Sarah Bryant, though, and our contestants. She comes in, but no, the Tetsujin, clinical. One soft kick, and there you go, 98.
No.
Well, our Tetsujin may have lost three rounds, but remember, he beat 99 opponents in a row. That's a total of 201 rounds he's fought. He had an unbroken run initially of 176 rounds, and he's decimated all his opponents in an average time of 43 seconds per fight. He really is a man of iron.
Okay, so the Tetsujin has battled his way through 99 contestants. This is the 100th. He is the most amazing arcade player we could land our hands upon. Please welcome Simon Nicolai from Sheffield.
OK, so Simon has travelled all the way down from Sheffield for this. He is quite literally not going to want to get beaten. He is carrying the pride of a nation upon his shoulders. Best of luck, Simon. Start your challenge. OK, so after Simon, interestingly, he is playing Cage. He's playing the same character as the Tetsujin. Is this going to be a good match, Dave?
Yeah, I think so. I think that's a really neat trick to pull off. Obviously, Sarah Bryant's been giving the Tetsujin the most trouble during the first. He's going to fall off into the trap.
Oh, that's it. It's a ring out. He was doing well there. He had the Tetsujin's energy down low, but he was flattering, only to deceive. One bite to nothing to the Tetsujin. Off and off for round two. I would hope we're not going to get a whitewash. This guy's the best that Britain has to offer. And again, it's the Tetsujin piling in there. Dave, I don't hold out much hope for our British competitor.
He's pushed towards the end of the platform again. He's got to watch that. That means the trick of using Cage as well. Through the Tetsujin, he's got behind him.
He's got behind him. He's still got the ring out.
That's revenge.
What a piece. So this is it. The whole day boils down to this one bout. He's beaten 99. Can the Tetsujin do the turn, or will Britain strike back with one winner of the day? It's the Tetsujin making the early running. I would thought it would have been tired, Dave, but this is nearly perfect.
It's nearly perfect. It looks like he's going to get a perfect one quick. Excellent, fantastic.
He does, quite literally almost tying with us. A perfect in the final bout. The Tetsujin does the 100. That was a masterful display, Mr. Tetsujin. The first thing I want to know is, was there any of our contestants who had Mr. Tetsujin worried?
Oh, 100人. 1から10、ちょっと動きとか読みづらい。だからちょっと負けそうになっちゃった。When
he was doing with experts, he's okay because he can predict what he's gonna do.
Yeah, he's used to playing against
experts.
Yeah.
But for example, if the person who has never done it play, who hasn't played it before, he can't predict what he's going to do. Yeah.
So it's more difficult against the rubbish players. Actually, interesting point. Was he ever very tired?
He said he can beat against 100 people still.
Oh, right, play another 100. Ah, fantastic. Mr. No Sleep, Tetsujin. Now, we're going to use Simon. You were the 100th challenger. We thought you might be the one who could topple the Tetsujin. And actually, remember, Sam, you are from Sheffield, so please feel free to use Naomi as an interpreter for the rest of the country as well. But how good was the Tetsujin?
Oh, he's excellent. He's an excellent player. And he's got a deep knowledge of the game. His reaction speed is incredible, and overall, he's just so quick, it's hard to touch.
You sounded very like a football manager in a post-match interview. That was very good, actually. I liked that. OK, well, we can't just give a normal joystick to Mr. Tetsujin, because this is the most incredible games playing feat we've probably ever seen. So we have a special enlarged Golden Games Master joystick for Mr. Tetsujin Bloke. Okay, that's it. On next week's show, we've got two cricketers, Adam Holyoake and my own personal cricketing hero, Mr. Philip Tufnell. They'll be on the show, and all that remains for me is to ask you this question. If the government privatised Tracy Shaw, would she become overpaid and inefficient overnight?